إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. أما بعد، وقال تعالى: وقالوا اتخذ الرحمن ولدا لقد جئتم شيئا إدا، تكاد السماوات يتفطرن منه وتنشق الأرض وتخر الجبال هدا، أن دعوا للرحمن ولدا وما ينبغي للرحمن أن يتخذ ولدا. We all know that tomorrow is the day of it's the 25th of December, which is the day of Christmas. And for some of us as Muslims, this could potentially present a problem in a way. Why is that? Because if you speak to some people, well, firstly, one of the most asked questions is, if someone says Merry Christmas to me or something like that, am I allowed to say Merry Christmas back to them? And many people feel the need to say it, because often there's this idea that if we completely disassociate ourselves from the people around us, everyone else is celebrating Christmas. If I just ignore them, it will somehow give a bad impression of Muslims. Some of you will have heard this. There's this idea that goes around: we need to, you know, do something. We can't completely disassociate ourselves, because if we do, it's very antisocial and it gives a bad impression. Like, Muslims are these people who just live here, but they're not actually part of our society. And this is not the case for everyone, but for some people, particularly people who are in the workplace, maybe people who are at university, people who are at schools, sometimes they feel the need that, okay, I need to be some part of this. I can't completely disappear now. Is that something that we can do? Is that something that we are allowed to do? And if we look at the verses which I read at the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they say that Ar-Rahman, the Most Merciful, has taken a son. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدًّا. You have brought an outrageous, a terrible claim. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتِ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضِ. The heavens, the skies, are about to rupture, to tear apart, and the earth is about to split open. وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضِ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا. And the mountains are about to collapse. أَنْ دَعُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدًا. That they would make such a claim. That people would make such a claim that Ar-Rahman, that Allah has taken a son. How can people make such a claim? أَنْ دَعُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدًا وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلرَّحْمَنِ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا. And it's not appropriate for Allah to take, it's not appropriate for Ar-Rahman to take a son. إِنْ كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِي الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا. Everyone in the heaven and the earth, there's not a person in heaven and the earth except that they will come to Ar-Rahman, to Allah, إِلَّا آتِي الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا, as a servant. And لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ عَدًّا. He's counted them all. وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. And on the day of judgment, everyone will come to Allah alone, by themselves. Now, if we read these verses, that the heavens are about to split, the heavens are about to tear apart, the earth is about to split, the mountains are about to collapse, all because of what? All because they made this claim. They made this claim that Allah has taken a son. And what is this? What is this festival supposed to be? It's supposed to be to celebrate the birth of this son, celebrating the birth of the one they say is the son of God. So if someone says Merry Christmas to me and I say Merry Christmas back, okay, I don't mean it, But effectively, but words at the end of the day, everything we say has a meaning. Whether we mean that or we mean something else. We don't actually mean what we're saying. The words we say have meaning. If someone says Merry Christmas to me and I say Merry Christmas back to them, what am I saying? I'm essentially saying, you know, congratulations on the birth of your God. Because this is the day that, this is, what if Christmas was supposed to be the celebration of the birth of the Son of God? So now we're saying congratulations on that. Of course we don't mean it, but still, is that really something we want to say? Do we really want to be saying something like this? If someone invites me to a Christmas party, or someone invites me to this or to that, do I really want to be going? Do I really want to be taking part in these things? If we look at these verses of Allah, if we read these verses of Allah, if we truly understand what the verses of the Quran here mean, none of us would want to come even near to doing such a thing. We make every effort that we can to get out of it in some way, in one way or another. Even if someone does say to me, Merry Christmas, would I actually say it back to them? And it's as Allah says in the Quran, وَتَحْسَبُونَهُ مَهَيِّنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. Allah says about something else. You may think it's small. You may think it's a little thing. You may think it's a small thing. But in the eyes of Allah, it's very big. So, do we really want to be going down that path? Do we really want to be okay, everyone else is celebrating Christmas, so when they say to me, I also need to say it back to them. And to be honest, the reality is, if we think about this carefully, if any of us feel the need to be taking part, to be celebrating this, if we do feel pressure to do this because we think, okay, we're going to look like we're not part of society, we're going to look like we're not contributing, we're going to look like we're just here, not interacting with everyone else. If we do feel that way, then in fact it's actually our fault. Why is it our fault? Because if we look at the way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we as Muslims are supposed to be contributing to society in a huge way, or not just on one day, not just on 1 month, or not just at a particular time, all throughout the year. For example, there's the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam where he says, "Kullu sulama min al-nasi alayhi sadaqa." On every organ of the people, there is a charity. "Kullu yomin tatlu'u fihi ash-shams." On every day that the sun rises. So every single day, we need to give a sadaqah. And what is a sadaqah? And then the hadith goes on to mention certain things. And some of them, and it doesn't say in any of these points, these things in the hadith are all about helping people. They're all about helping people. They're all about being good to people, being kind to people. And it doesn't say in any of these places it's just for Muslims. It doesn't say, okay, just for the Muslim people you need to be good to them. Because, for example, in the hadith it says, وَتُعِينُ الرَّجُلَ فِي دَابَّتِهِ فَتَحْمِلُهُ عَلَيْهَا أَوْ تَرْفَعُ لَهُ مَتَاعَهُ صَدَقَةً. That you help a person with his mount. You either you help him to get onto it, or you help him to lift his luggage onto it, to put his luggage on his mount. Or naturally we say on someone, we help someone get into their car, or help someone to put their luggage into their car. And it doesn't say just for Muslims, right? Simple little things like this, helping people, these are very important in the religion. And then the hadith goes on to say, وَالْكَلِمَةُ الطَّيِّبُ صَدَقَةً. Saying a good word, just saying a good word, this is sadaqah, this is a charity. These are the things we need to be doing every day. And it doesn't say anywhere here, it just has to be for Muslims. As we also know, for example, smiling, just giving a smile, that is a charity. وَتُمِيقُ الْأَذَىٰ عَنِ الطَّرِيقِ صَدَقَةً. Most of us would have heard of this. Just removing litter from the path is sadaqah. Cleaning the street, that's sadaqah. All these things, they're about what? They're about being kind to the people. They're about helping the people. And if we look at the verse of the Quran as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسَ فَيَنْفُذُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. What benefits the people, that's what remains in the earth. So if we are beneficial to the people, if we are kind to the people, then no doubt the people would love us. And if we look at the people of the past, who used to follow the Prophet in what he did, everyone wanted to be with them. Everyone wanted Muslims to live with them. Everyone wanted to be the neighbors of Muslims. We don't even have to look at anyone else, we just look at the Prophet himself, because if we look at the incident when he received revelation, and he came back he received the first revelation, he came back to Khadija radiallahu anha, and he said, you know, I fear that something evil may have happened to me. What did Khadija say? She said, كَلَّا لَا يُغْزِيكَ اللَّهُ أَبَدًا. No way Allah would not forsake you ever. Why is that? Why did he say that? Innaka she said, Innaka latasilu rahim. You keep the ties of kinship. You are good to all your relatives. Watasdukul hadith, and you are true, you're truthful. You always speak the truth. Watahmilul kalb, and you take on the burdens of other people. You know, when other people are finding things difficult, you help them. And you help the one who is destitute. And you are good to the guest. You're good to your guest. You're hospitable with your guest. And then you help the people, you help everyone, you help the society. So throughout history, every single Muslim who's followed the Prophet ﷺ in this, every single one has been wanted by the society, has been popular among the society. Everyone in the society has wanted to live next to them. And of course we know that as Allah says in the Quran, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. Allah says in the Quran, if you love Allah, then you follow me. You follow the Messenger of Allah. We can see the Prophet in this scenario, this is before he received revelation, everyone wanted to be with him. Everyone loved him. Every single person in society called him Al-Amin, the trustworthy one. Obviously, after the revelation came, then for some other reason, they turned against him. But before that, everyone, because of this, everyone loved him. If we truly love Allah, then we should follow the Prophet in this, just as we try and follow him in everything else. So now the question that each one of us needs to ask ourselves is, are we those people? Are we the ones who everyone wants to live with? Are we the ones who everyone wants as a neighbor? Or are we the people who block people's driveways without parking? Are we the people who, in Ramadan after Taraweeh, we stay outside speaking to each other very loudly all night and keep everyone awake? Which type of people are we? And that's for each one of us to answer ourselves. We need to think about it. So if we are the second category of people, then it's no wonder that some feel the need that, okay, when Christmas comes and everyone's being nice to everyone, we also need to take part, otherwise we'll look like, you know, we'll stand out like a sore thumb, we'll look very bad. The reality is, as I said, this couldn't be further from the truth. Because, as I said, if we were truly following Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam throughout the whole year, we were the most popular people in society, we were the kindest people in society, we were the people who everyone wants to live with, then if on Christmas Day we don't turn up to a Christmas party, who's going to care? No one's going to mind at all. And in fact, this idea of just doing it one day in the year is a very bad way of doing things. And it's not something that we as Muslims should be looking at. Like the idea that okay, one day during the year everyone's gonna be very nice to each other, we're all going to be very kind to each other, it's the season of giving gifts and stuff like that. This is not an idea from Islam. It's a Western concept. Just like this thing about Mother's Day and Father's Day, right? As a Muslim, this is in fact an insult to the mother and the father. Every day should be Mother's Day and Father's Day. It doesn't make sense to take one day out of the year and say, okay, today is the day for my mother and today is the day for my father. The same with Christmas. Like, okay, if we as Muslims are good to the people, kind to the people, beneficial to the people throughout the year, then on Christmas Day, no one's going to mind if you don't say Merry Christmas back to them, or you don't turn up to their Christmas party, or so on. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us those people who, as Allah says in the Quran, وَأَمَّا مَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ فَيَمْكُثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ, the people who are beneficial to the others, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He helps us to follow the Prophet in every single aspect of His life. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. The second problem which Christmas can potentially pose is that it is to do with our children. Our children who go to school, they see everyone else, all the other children enjoying Christmas, they see all the Christmassy stuff in school, everyone's getting a Christmas tree at home. And then, oftentimes, we might find that they want to take part. They want to also be part of it. Why can't we also celebrate Christmas? Everyone else celebrate Christmas. And This could be because we are not making Eid, our Eid, a big enough thing. As the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ قَوْمٍ عِيدًا. Every nation has their celebration. Every nation has their festive day. وَهَذَا عِيدُنَا. And this is our Eid. And as we know, in Islam, there are the two Eid. So we need to make sure that when it comes to Eid, we make it a big deal. We celebrate it. We plan for it. And now, you know, some people might think, sometimes we have this idea that, you know, celebration is not really the way things should be, and we're all about, you know, we sometimes neglect that, we sometimes forget that aspect. And no doubt it's true that as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created the mankind except to worship me. So no doubt it's true that the purpose of our creation is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in fact, this is side point here. Side point. Did you know that the only two days, in fact, the two Eid, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha, those are the two days where we have an extra prayer. Right? Did you ever think about that? The only two days in the whole year where we have an extra prayer are the two Eid, the two days of celebration. But in fact, on the two days of celebration, what do we know? We actually pray another prayer. So we have the five prayers and then we have the Eid. So for example, Jumu'ah, it's not that we have an extra prayer, we have the Salat Jumu'ah in the place of Eid. So if that doesn't show to us just the importance of this verse, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, if that doesn't show to us how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us only to worship Him, then you know that then nothing else will. Now you contrast this with others from maybe other religions who they're not religious at all throughout the year. They don't do any worship, and then when the time for celebration is there, when the day of celebration is there, the festival, then everyone turns up. So in Islam, no doubt the big emphasis is on worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But even so, we should not neglect the fact that the day of Eid, or the two days of Eid, should be days of celebration. Celebration should be carried out on those days. And as we know in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, what she says that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came to my house while there were two Ansari girls, two girls of the Ansar, who were singing some songs of the Ansar from previous days. Abu Bakr said, musical instruments of Satan in the house of the Prophet. How can this be? How can you have these in the house of the Prophet? And Aisha radiallahu anha said, it happened on the day of Eid, and the Prophet said to him, O Abu Bakr, there is an Eid for every nation, and today is our Eid. There is a festival for every nation, and today is our festival. So clearly, if we look at this, we can see that actually, even as Muslims, on the day of Eid, there should be some kind of celebration. So we need to realize as well that the less we do for Eid, the more our children will want to celebrate something like Christmas. So there should be a big emphasis on that as well. And like everything else, we should plan for Eid. So now we've got, you know, how much time. So the Eid al-Fitr, which will be after Ramadan, and the Eid al-Adha. Particularly if you have small children, if you have young children who go to school, who see everyone else celebrate Christmas, this should be a big priority for you. We should be planning for Eid from now. What are you going to do on Eid al-Fitr? What are you going to do on Eid al-Adha? So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows us to practice our religion to the best of our ability. عباد الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقيموا الصلاة